there's so many questions that buyers have that still aren't getting answered in the form of content. People want to do all their research online. Start answering all those questions with your content, may that be blogs, video, podcasts, whatever, but they'll find that content and now you're in front of them all the time.
This interview is brought to you by Kimberly Mackey, founder of NewHomesSolutions.com. Kimberly Mackey is a sales and marketing management consultant, keynote speaker, and new home sales trainer. Her real-world experience brings sales and management solutions to home builders. Visit NewHomesSolutions.com.
Look at this. Can I pull one? Can we pull one? Let's see if we can do this. We're gonna try to get this up in here. Okay. No. This is not easy. Dude, you do not make this easy on me, do you? Okay, watch this. I'm gonna get the bottom one. I'm going bottom. Woo! Here we go. What's gonna happen? Ready? Here we go. I'm pulling it out. I'm pulling it out. I'm pulling it out. I'm pulling it out. Woo! There we go. Now I gotta put it up on top, right? That's what I'm talking about. I think it would have been more cool if it fell, but we're not going to do that. Hey everybody, NewHomeSales.com here at Builder Books at the International Builder Show. Las Vegas, Nevada, Spencer Powell, Builder Funnel. How's the show going, man?
Oh, man, it's awesome. I mean, 100,000 people, there's just chaos, but tons of learning, lots of people to meet.
I'm glad that you confirmed that because I've been telling people 100,000, but honestly, I don't know how many people. It just feels like 100,000.
Yeah, I heard that from somebody else, so don't quote me.
It was probably me.
Let's just, we rounded to 100, so okay. Yeah.
Listen, man, you're doing big things. Tell me about Builder Funnel.
Yeah, so we're a digital agency, and we focus on lead generation for builders. And so we do a lot with content, SEO, social media. It's really about embracing the inbound process, which is consumers are out there looking for information, and you have to create that content to attract them to you.
I'm seeing a big trend with that, like leads. Like, it's not even... Like, there's a limited number of buyers, and then there's everybody's going after them. The brokers are going after them, the companies, the Zillows, the Trulia. So what are you different? What do you as a company do different to, or, okay, what advice would you have for people trying to capture leads?
I would say really today you have to have a high-performing website that is built to convert, but I think a lot of people are forgetting that there's so many questions that buyers have that still aren't getting answered in the form of content. We want to drive them to the model and talk to somebody. People want to do all their research online. Start answering all those questions with your content, may that be blogs, video, podcasts, whatever, but they'll find that content and now you're in front of them all the time.
But aren't they trying to, because I've heard people are trying to eliminate you, not trying to buy from you. So where's the balance? Like, are you trying to sell or are you trying to just attract them? I mean, what's the balance there?
Yeah, I think, you know, in my mind, if you're a builder, you want to try to control as much of the marketing message that you can. And so by creating that content, you're attracting them to your site. Now you can nurture them, you can build your credibility and your trust with them, and then you can get them to come into a model and they'll go through the sales process. But really, you want to capture them while they're on your website so that you can continue to stay in front.
Good point. I think that, like, people are so, like, if you're hiding information, you can Google it, right? So the precedent's been set by Google. So if you're like, oh, you have to come in first, it's like, no, screw you. Like, I'm going to get to that. I want it now. You know what I mean?
Yeah, and they're going to find that information somewhere. So you might as well have them find it on your site versus somebody else's site.
Okay, you're a digital guy. What's the biggest mistake you see companies making? Because I want content for somebody who's trying to do what you're doing. I want you to give away your magic sauce.
Sure. I would say the biggest mistake is that they're not converting what we would call top of the funnel leads. So somebody comes to the website, they're thinking about buying a home, but they're not quite ready. They're researching. offer them something of a little extra value, but they have to give up some information to do that. So a home buyer's checklist, a home design guide, something that they can fill out a quick little form and get access to it. And now you can stay in front via email and nurture that relationship. And what we're seeing is that once you implement that strategy, I mean, you can triple the number of leads and form submissions you get through your website pretty easily. And that's a huge missed opportunity if you're not doing that.
Okay, what's the most successful campaign? Was it a checklist? Was it a video form? Was it picture form? Was it just information? Tell me a specific campaign, like top 10 mistakes, or what was a checklist that you used?
Yeah, I would say we've had a few different ones that are pretty successful, but one is just like a home design guide, because people are always interested in design. And so you can talk about the process of what goes into that, how that works. But then quick things like a checklist, those oftentimes they want to know like, oh, this is my home buyer's checklist. So that campaign worked really well, because they're like, hey, I've never done this before. What am I going to go through? Oh, here's all the bullet points. And they'll give up name and email for that, no problem.
Where do you create your own checklist? Do you research it? Do you Google it, read books? Or where do you get a checklist?
So we create those checklists, and then for us, we create them for our clients. So then that content is theirs, and they use it to convert the leads, and we're just using that as a tool to capture leads for them.
Maybe a silly question, but how do you, like, let's say you're working with multiple builders, it's like, hey, do this, and it's like, okay, wow, and then you get a checklist, then you do another builder, then it gets the same checklist. How do you avoid stuff like that?
Yeah, it's a great question, not a silly one. We don't work with competing companies, so that's how we solve that. It's like, hey, if we're partnered with you, we want to help you dominate your area and your space, and so anything we're creating for you, we're not going to create for a competitor.
That seems weird, though. Like, what if D.R. Horton or Toll Brothers is like, hey, Builder Funnel, come work for us. Oh, you know, we're national. You have to fire everybody? Like, what do you do in that situation?
Yeah, so we work with a lot of local guys or regional, and so we're not working with the national companies, okay. And that's not our focus. Yeah.
That's a great question. Okay. Give me one, two, or three just like tips, the biggest thing that when you see a website, you're like, oh, I hate that. I cringe when I see it.
That's a good question. I mean, for me, I would say a lot has to do with just the overall design being like super loud and noisy, and there's just like too many options. So I think simplify would be a big one. And then not enough information actually is really frustrating. And I kind of cringe when I see that, because I go, gosh, they're probably spending money, good money, to drive people here. But then the people are leaving because they can't get all the information they want. So I see sometimes there's not enough floor plan information, or, you know, information about the communities or whatever that may be. I'd say like create as much information as you can and try to organize it. It's kind of a dichotomy there, because I'm saying create a lot but simplify. But I think you can do that through ease of navigation and just making sure everything is really focused.
All right. Now we connected through, what's your URL?
Builderfunnel.com.
Okay, now look, what you have really, which is really interesting, is a platform. You have a national platform. Is it a podcast, video cast? And you have some of the top salespeople, marketing professionals, different angles. Tell me about that.
Yeah, so we started Builder Funnel Radio a little over a year ago. And our main goal there was, one, we felt it was a good marketing channel for us. But two, we said, hey, a lot of these guys, they're on the go. They don't want to read all our blogs anymore, you know, because we're creating a lot of blog content. And we said, they're at the gym, they're driving to job sites, they're on the go. Let's give them a different format to consume content and learn and educate themselves. And that was how the podcast was born. We said, hey, let's bring in, you know, guests. Originally, it started as like, hey, we'll just kind of talk about marketing topics. And then we figured, that'll get boring really fast. So let's bring in some experts and start hosting them on the show. And yeah, it just kind of ballooned from there. And yeah, it's been a lot of fun.
A lot of the show, the reason I bring it up, a lot of people right now are trying to create a digital platform, a YouTube videos. They're trying to do blogging and, you know, podcasts. So what's the biggest mistake you made? What are some interview tips? What are some suggestions for an inspiring platform builder?
Yeah, I would say in terms of the podcast, the big mistake we did was not starting with video and audio. The video has actually turned into a good piece. We've been able to take like a 40-minute episode, chop it up into five little segments, put it on LinkedIn, on Instagram, on Facebook. And people have been saying that they've been seeing me there a lot more. So maybe somebody is going to subscribe to the podcast and they'll listen to 40 minutes. But first, they want that little bite. They want the 3-minute you know, nugget from that episode. They'll watch the video, they'll maybe see four or five, and then they'll actually subscribe and go, oh, there's a full episode, and they don't realize that. I think with marketing, we always look at our stuff and we know what we've created, but our audience is just getting exposed to us. So just being able to hit them with all these little pieces of great information. So including the video was a big mistake. We didn't do that early on.
So you're a digital guy, but who have you learned from on the platform building side, and who's been your inspiration? Is Gary Vaynerchuk? You watching, you know, anything on, who have been some of the YouTube channels that you follow, books, anything?
Yeah, so I mean, Gary Vaynerchuk is one we were just talking about a little bit before. He's been kind of an inspiration because, I mean, if you watch a lot of his content, you're like, man, he must just have guys with cameras following around everywhere he goes and just clipping this stuff up. And then there's another guy that I follow, Andy Frisella, and he has a supplement superstore and First Form. He's in the fitness space, but he does a really good job with his podcast and then clipping it up and using different things on social media.
Speaking of camera guys, we have hey, Cody. Is this your media? Who is Cody? He's out here taking pictures.
Yeah, Cody's with me here, and we just said, hey, we've got to embrace video too if we're recommending it to our clients. And so we've been out here doing some interviews and taking some photos.
Stay here, but I'm going to just ask you a couple of questions. So first off, what kind, and by the way, when you, for the podcast, what equipment do you use? What do you recommend, or what do you, have you bought stuff that was bad? What do you like, not like?
Yeah, so we have a podcast microphone. So there's one called the Blue Yeti, which is the one that we use. And we've just been using Zoom to capture, but then, Cody would know better on the video camera side. He could probably answer that question for equipment. Yeah.
See, you want to hear something funny? Just a funny podcast story. I was invited to be on this podcast, and they're like, it is echoey, right? And they're like, is there a blanket? And I'm like, sure. And literally, I like put a blanket under my head. Like, so I'm in the dark talking on the phone. So there's just weird things that you have to do. Cody, man, thanks for being on the program, man. How long have you been with Builder Funnel?
At the very end of last year, actually. So just kind of came on with them, and I'm excited to be with them.
So do you love photography? Do you love art? Do you love platform building? What is your why? What gets you up excited?
I love film. I love being behind the camera, teaching people how to use the camera, being able just to mess around with all the different techniques and stuff just to see like what an image or video will come out to be, and that's kind of really what got me into this position. And just,
I know you're like, you're here doing the film, so I'm changing the camera, but people are interested, like what kind of equipment, or what do you edit the film? Are you going to college for this? Are you studying it through books, or how do you learn what you're doing, and what programs are you using?
I actually just graduated from college back in 2017 from film school, and so.
Which film school?
Colorado Film School. It's a great program. It's only a 3-year university, but got out of there and found Builder Funnel and been working. Right now I have the Canon 6D. That's usually the best with like low quality lighting and that type of stuff as well, and so we can get more light on our subject even if we don't have the best lighting in the actual podcast room. We do have 4 LED lights that we place up around our main subject. We have one main light, kind of a bounce light, and then we also have one more so kind of behind the subject.
What brands and what's a bounce light?
A bounce light, good question. A bounce light's more just kind of a light on the side that just kind of reflects the light on the actual subject, and then you all have the main light, which is the one usually right in front and right by the camera, which is your main source of light that you'll have on the subject. And then the LED lights are just very powerful battery lights that we have that we use on.
Did you learn more in college, or just like getting out and actually doing it, or watching YouTube? Tell me about that.
Actually going out and doing it is probably where I learned most of my stuff. I mean, even just with this camera, I had it for about a year now, and I'm still learning new things about it, just going out and just taking photos and videos. And even here, I'm learning new things about how this works. And
you watch other people, right? And what's the thing that makes you cringe, whether you're like, oh God, I hate that?
It's probably bad audio. Bad audio.
We have good audio.
Yeah, I was like, we had full mic and everything, cordless, and that looks awesome. But yeah, I was like, it's mostly audio. If you don't have good audio, you don't can't really tell the story. You can't really get, you might have a good image, but what's the story there? And so you have to have that story, and the audio is really what picks it up. And so
I think it's really cool just with the technology that, you know, you're able to build a platform, reach people on a national level, you know, buy as a bright product, you're connecting and associating, you're sharing other people's stuff. You know, trying to be a video influencer and things, is that, I don't know, any input on that?
Being a video influencer, I mean, I like it. Just kind of being able to put my name and stuff out there, and then being able to put my artistic ability into the work that Builder Funnel does. And I do it all in the editing. I use Final Cut Pro. It's a little expensive of a software, but it does exactly what we need to do. And
is he good?
It's good.
No. Is he good?
Oh, is he good? Yeah. And it saves me a lot of time because I know nothing about that, but that's his strength. And it's kind of funny. You kind of asked like about the platform and what's it like. I'm an introvert, so a lot of this is fairly uncomfortable, but this is what people want to see. They want to watch stuff. They don't want to read stuff, and they're consuming more and more videos. So we just said, hey, we've got to embrace this, and especially for our clients, if we're saying, hey, you need to be utilizing video, then we've kind of got to eat our own dog food.
One tip on that, because people are like, do I stare at the camera? Do I stare at you? Have them look at you, because we're just having a conversation, right? If they're looking at the camera, especially if it's got a monitor, they're always trying to time it and look at themselves, and it's very awkward. That's a tip I learned really early from Ann Ladwig. Thank you, Ann. Cody, give me some filming tips, some photography tips, just like one, two, or three, like anything.
Make sure that your subject is well lit, that you have great sound, and that they're in focus. And make sure you want to focus mostly on the eyes, because that's where everything's really at, and that's where the story is, and that's where the soul is of a person. And so if you can get those three things, you can at least start off heading in the right direction. And so
listen, man, I appreciate that. It's an honor having you on the program. It's neat to see the people behind the scenes. What's the one thing you've learned from this show?
The one thing I've learned from this show is you just got to be patient. It's not really going to go quite how you think it's going to go. And so when it comes to editing and that type of stuff in the end, it's just more kind of being patient and just listening and grasping really what the subject's saying on the podcast. And
okay. Here's something good. You know what people love even more than success? Failure, right? They want to know, like, what was your biggest mistake? What's the most embarrassing thing, like, you've done, or just anything on a program, like, you did it? I could tell you some of mine. Like, I recorded, I was talking to Mary Marshall Adams, and halfway through the interview, I'm like, oh my gosh, I didn't even press record. Any, like, super dumb things that you've done?
Not yet for this podcast, but there's been some other things to where just like...
Tell me something fun. Like
one of the lights fell off, just kind of fell in the back behind one of the subjects, and I just kind of stood there and I was like, just keep going, I guess. Like, there's nothing, you're live. I was like, there's nothing we can really do right now, and so they just had to continue going with it. And
what about you? Anything like just forgetting somebody's name, just something like space out, lock up? And the reason why I'm telling this is because everybody's so afraid. They think this is CBS News. It's not, man. Like, we're all learning, we're doing this stuff. People want to see us make mistakes, right? Anything that you've done that was embarrassing?
Honestly, if you go back and watch my first YouTube videos from like 2010, when I did something called Social Media Summer, and I thought that would be a good idea to just put out like a video a day. I did that for 90 days. It is so awful. I'm so bad on camera. I should pull them down, but I just left them there because it's...
Because people got to see where you came from, right? The progression.
Yeah.
Always be what? Improving, man. You know what I mean?
Absolutely. Yeah. So that for me, like, that was the first thing that came to mind, was just like, those are so bad. And I'm sure people look at my stuff now and say, oh, maybe it's not the best, or, oh, they're never going to be in the movies. But that's all right. I'm going to keep chipping away.
Hey, listen, we're going to builderfunnel.com. I'm excited, man. We're going to see big things for Cody. Keep doing things, man. Keep making a positive impact in the lives of other people. Here with Spencer and Cody with builderfunnel.com here at the International Builder Show. And don't forget to subscribe to newhomesales.com. We're going to be bringing you lots of videos from the International Builder Show.